All right, guys, today I'm doing some footing for Bill. Let's go over and talk to Bill. Bill's a patron. He's been trying to get this building built for 3 years, so let's go talk to him. Over there pulling weeds. I knew Bill would want to help me, so yesterday he helped me lay this out, and we're gonna get Piers, and he's down there pulling weeds. I never thought I would find somebody that has OCD worse than me, but I think I found him.
Hey, Bill. I was just telling Justin that I don't think I have ever found anybody that has OCD as bad as me, but I think I found somebody that has it more.
Yeah, mine's kicked in pretty heavy today.
So are you excited to get going on this?
Beyond excited.
Yeah. 3 years, I think it's taken Bill to get to this point. Looking after, for property.
After several different properties and then dealing with the city.
Yeah.
Threw in the towel and came out to the country and
yeah,
get it done.
So we're going to get pouring some footing, or drilling all these holes, get all the forms, then tomorrow morning we're going to pour your footing. So
I think it'll probably take us, I don't know,
I think 4 hours probably to drill all these, maybe. We'll see.
What's the size of this, Bill?
60 by 120.
And 16-foot sidewalls, and what are you going to be putting in this? Cars, right?
Cars. Classic cars.
Yeah.
6 car lifts.
Are you going to let us come back and check it out?
Oh, yeah.
The cars are in?
Do the final
yeah,
walkthrough and everything.
It'd be pretty cool to fly the drone through one door with all the cars lined up and out the other.
Yeah, that would be.
All right, well, let's get going, I guess. Hard on the knees, Justin. I brought some knee pads.
Got some knee pads if you want them.
What did I just say, Justin?
I said, should have brought some.
I, every time I do this, I first time I kneel down, I'm like, I need to get something to kneel on. That's wisdom right there, Bill, what that is.
Well, let me go get it.
I think I would have that at 44.
Yeah.
Sometimes that pain feels good. Yeah, look at that, Bill. I like it. I mean, that's nice. Enjoyment of doing these just went up a little bit. pretty close every time, Justin. What's going on? As long as I'm within a quarter, I'm happy. So the water line, electrical line was put in, so they got a trench here and it happens to land right on 8 foot. So if you're gonna do that beforehand, you might wanna try to figure out where in between the columns are. All right, I'll put my string line up, see where 8 foot lands. That should be able to get my drill to start. Four and then two of your stakes. All right, you're right here. You be here at seven tomorrow?
Seven? Is that what time the four is?
I just gotta, if you can, it's not the four.
No, I can.
Bill, are you wanting to help pour the pier? 7 a.m. Well, I think we're ready, Justin, other than cutting half of those off. All right, it is pour day. Concrete truck's gonna be here in like 10 minutes. I had to send Justin back to my house because I forgot the rebar for the dead man. The dead man's are just the holes that we put some rebar in so we can put chains, straps, all that kind of stuff too, to kind of hold our building in place if we get some bad weather. So without rebar, it doesn't do a whole lot of good to pour them. So I sent him to get that, so he's gonna be running a little late. But I think we're all ready other than that. So hopefully this goes well. Justin just got here. We're about half done. It is 7:43 and we're about half done. So this probably takes about an hour and a half to pour all of these. I already got my string lines ready and then we can start marking out. So we're ready to set all these brackets because that can really turn on you fast. I can tell you this JCB Teleskid and SkidPro concrete bucket make this so much easier than what it is trying to back these trucks in and around all these holes. So one little trick, I've done this a lot by myself, so that's why I like doing these square batter boards, because then I just screw a 2x4 in, and then I make this, I put a screw in so it's an even number. So this string line is actually set for the post, so I just come back, I set 3 feet and 1.5 inches back. So now I can just pull my 8 foot on centers from here. It's a nice easy way to be able to pull a tape by yourself. Bill, I got another level on the thing. This is definitely going to be ready to go here. So what I'm doing is I'm lining my black mark up here on my string line with this down here, making sure I'm level right here, plumb, and then I'm just setting this off about 1/8 to 1/4 inch. And that's close enough. Now I need to get my other tape for that corner.
Paul, I think I've got it.
And then what I do, these are kind of bent, so you can't put it on the side. So what I do, and I just make sure it's kind of close, because those are gonna move. Right. So we don't have to worry about that much. But that's an excellent job. So about 1/8 inch to 1/4, and we're good.
Okay.
So I have those two marked. I'll do the corner ones.
Yep.
Of these bent at one time, but I used them all. All right, whenever we do a bigger building, we'll put these dead mans in or use big concrete anchors. This is honestly easier if you don't have to pull them back out. This is in the driveway, so it's gonna be fine. The other ones are gonna be covered in the inside. So we just take a piece of rebar, bend it over. Let's set it, and then we can put a, you can honestly hook your chains right to it, or you can put a clevis on it and hook all your chains to the clevis. Alright guys, so we're done pouring all the footings here. This is a build that has kind of been in the works for a few years. Bill is the guy we're building it for. He's been wanting this for a while, and he's bought a couple different pieces of property. Finally got to this one. It's going to be a really cool build. It's 60 by 120. It's going to be red and then have a darker roof, so I think it's going to be really neat looking, but it's going to be full of antique classic cars, so it'll be pretty sweet. He'll let us come back and check it out once that's all done. This one's getting finished on the inside and everything. But a couple things, when you're pouring these footings, you want to make sure you have kind of everything ready to go when the concrete trucks get there. This concrete bucket and skid steer is a life changer for me. It really makes things easy not having to get that concrete truck in and around all these holes. So I did make some modifications to my bucket that really have helped, which we'll kind of jump to that and kind of show you what we did. but that allows me as an operator to fill all the holes without any help. And then it's beefed up the bottom so that, you know, over the time of opening and closing the hydraulic door, it doesn't bend that bottom chute. And then I also added some supports to the chute so I can really shake that bucket to get the concrete out. So a few things I did is this plate right here. I welded this on to the front of my concrete bucket. And the reason I did that is so that I can fill this thing all the way. And then I can tip the bucket enough that I can see the front of the chute from inside the cab before, if I tipped it up high enough, the first hole, the concrete would want to run over the top. So that's why I welded this on. Obviously, I switched my hoses to the other side because I have a JCB, and JCB's hydraulics are on the right, which is not typical. And then we beefed up this bottom plate here, and then added all of these little pins, pin supports, so that when I put this on there, I can hook this down there and I can squeeze that tight. This is just a turnbuckle. And then I can really shake this bucket and this doesn't flop around. So I still have the ability to take it off, but it also makes it nice and secure as well. All right, that's gonna be a wrap on these footings here. Stay tuned because we'll be building this here within starting this within the next month or so. We appreciate you guys all watching. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, share us with your friends, and we will catch you on the next video.